This is Blake Suniga alongside Tim Swartz and Brian Vanifatemi, and we're excited for some 2K Hoops.
A look now at the starting lineups for both teams.
Well, in this salary cap league, rookie contracts have massive value.
The lower cap numbers, they really help with team building. If you have a few players on rookie scale deals, that frees up space to go up after a big free agent or two.
And that's why the WNBA draft is so crucial for teams. If you can just find a keeper, you have a big leg up on the competition.
Now here's Brown.
Go, go, go!
Ogumike outside. Pass to Canada. Shot clock at 5. And Ogumike gets it to go.
No one in the WNBA deals with D inside like Ogumike. She figures out ways to beat even great defense.
Here's Cunningham. Now here's Griner. 14 feet out, and the jumper falls for her.
They can't afford to give her that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you have to fight over the top of it.
And you need some help as well.
Now here is Ogumike. Brittany Griner with a defensive effort. About 1 minute played here so far in the first.
As good as Chinne Ogumike is at playing basketball, I mean, she might be even better talking about it. Chinne is one of the top NBA analysts.
Here's Taurasi. Pass to Jefferson. Now Griner. She's covered by Ogumike. Griner misses.
Well, that's just not a sight you see very often because she has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when she's open.
Here's Brown. Good, and Jordan Canada gets the assist. And since 2018, Chinne Ogumike has been an NBA TV analyst for a big network.
And Chinne's knowledge isn't just limited to hoops. Ogumike became the first black female and the first WNBA player to have a national daily sports radio show.
That one, good for two.
The wily vet, Taurasi, incredible court vision.
And it's the Sparks ball. And the outside. And count the basket. She was fouled, and she's going to the line for one more.
One of the more respected players in the WNBA has to be Nneka Ogumike. She's won a record number of sportsmanship awards.
One shot.
In addition to NECA's on-the-court reputation, off the floor, she's very well regarded.
Serving as the president of the Players Union for years, NECA has been instrumental in fighting for players' rights, making major strides when it comes to compensation and benefits. Well, when you look at the all-time leaders in points scored, Diana Taurasi is first by a wide margin. That speaks to her incredible longevity.
Entering the league in 2004, Diana Taurasi continues to be great.
Well, part of it is her legendary competitiveness. I mean, Taurasi plays with incredible fire, and that flame is still burning strong.
And she knocks down the first one.
When you talk about who is the GOAT, the greatest of all time, Diana Taurasi is certainly in the mix. She has more first-team all-WNBA selections than any player ever.
And she makes both free throws.
An original WNBA team going back to the inaugural 1997 season, the Los Angeles Sparks have been a pillar in the league.
Now here is Hamby, and Ogumike gets it to go.
You got to do more than that to stop Ogumike, one of the best built players in the WNBA.
And it's so nice, we gotta see it twice. How about that mobile one drive?
Just tremendous intensity going downhill on that drive. Love the attack mentality in a close game.
Out to the wing. Here's Cunningham. She's covered by Ogumike. Pass to Cunningham. To Rossi. And again, Phoenix no good. And as Brian said, this Los Angeles franchise is so important to the league.
Well, they've won lots of games, hung banners, developed some stars, and they've never moved or been rebranded. Since 1997, the Sparks have been there every step of the way.
Phoenix trailing here. Screen by Griner. Pass to Jefferson. The Mercury with another miss.
They got lucky. They got lucky. And the defense has taken a big chance, leaving her open behind the arc. And I'm not sure I'm okay with that game plan.
Now here's Brown. Ogumike up top. She's covered by Jefferson. And basket is good. Got it to go through the contact. So a free throw coming up. Opportunity for a three-point play.
The first overall pick back in 2012, Nneka Ogumike has adjusted her game, adding the three-point shot, becoming a modern stretch four.
One shot.
What an impressive job Nneka has done adding that three-point stroke.
Well, after making just 7 threes over her first 4 WNBA seasons, Ogumike added that long-distance shot and remade herself into a stretch four. Just goes to show you how talented Nneka is.
Now, here is Ogumike. 10 points for her. To the paint. Over Griner. Ogumike can't hit.
Yeah, she's not necessarily a strong interior presence, but she's got to finish those chances when she has them.
Here's Onyewede. Now Griner. They need this. It's good, and she drew the contact on the shot, so she'll go to the line. A three-point play opportunity.
When we talk defensive impact, no player affects a game like Brittany Griner. Quite simply, the best defender in WNBA history.
A perennial all-defensive team member, Griner is the ultimate rim protector.
Well, you have 6'9 height, 7'4 wingspan, incredible motor, and a tremendous defensive IQ. All of that shows up in Brittany's block numbers.
Here's Cloudon, screened by Ogumike. It's stolen by Griner. Now here's Onyewede. Here's Sutton. She hasn't yet put up any points in this one. A nice shot by Griner.
With an incredible motor, Griner plays with the attitude of someone just trying to make the team, not the all-world superstar she is.
Here's Cloudon. From 11 feet away, the Sparks no good that time either. And here's Sutton. Here's Westbrook, and it's good. The game is all even. Now Cloudon. Pass to Holmes. Ogumike. To the middle. Here's Cloudon. Yes, and a nice assist from Neko Ogumike.
Recognizing the defense's miscues and capitalizing on them, that's part of what makes Ogumike so special. Right there, she's able to find someone wide open.
7 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. And here's Griner. She's covered by Ogumike. Griner, good.
What a start to this game. All offense early.
Yeah, this is just playground stuff. Forget about defending. Just keep letting it fly.
That's okay with me.
Pass to Ogumike. And the shot counts. She's fouled. That's a chance for a three-point play.
And this gets Ogumike going, showing muscle and focus by converting through the physical defense.
This is her third trip to the free throw line.
One shot.
The WNBA's Rookie of the Year in 2012, Ogumike entered the league with a bang. And since then, she hasn't really taken her foot off the gas.
And at the end of one, both teams putting up some points. The Sparks on top, they're up by three. Let's take a quick break, and then it's on to the second quarter after this. And it's been a tight one here as the second quarter getting going. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from the Sparks. Guys?
There hasn't been a lot of settling for outside shots really early on.
Yeah, they've done a good job to work it low and not take the easy way out on offense. No shortcuts.
Pound it low.
In the WNBA, free agency has become much more important over the last few years.
Yeah, Blake, I mean, take Candace Parker's move from L.A. to Chicago. She signs with the Sky in 2021, and Candace was key in Chicago winning their first ever WNBA championship. We are seeing, over the last couple years, as you said, more impact signings.
And that's great for the league because the offseason has just become so interesting. And I like to see star players getting to choose where they go. It makes the league really exciting.
Back to Canada. Shot clock at six. Cook. And that'll be Los Angeles ball as it goes out of bounds. Sparks able to keep the ball here. To Canada, and here's Brown. Just five on the clock. Canada, and the three off target. And we played through the first minute here in the second.
The WNBA had its first season back in 1997, and just three original teams remain: the LA Sparks, the New York Liberty, and the Phoenix Mercury.
Now Taurasi, fade away. And there's a whistle. That goes on Turner. That's her first foul. The Sparks with the lead. Canada with it. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. And the basket by Hamby. Sticking in the Valley of the Sun, the Mercury have had so much success.
Yeah, in so many different eras. I mean, they were in their first finals, which was the second WNBA finals ever back in 1998. Then you had their glory years, winning three titles from 2007 to 2014. And then recently, they've been to the finals as well. It's just been decades of winning basketball in the desert.
Well, that pick, it worked like a charm. A nice job taking it right to the tin for the layup.
Outside Canada. to the inside. Pass to Holmes. She can't hit that time. Brittany Griner with a defensive effort. And so here is Phoenix. They've only given up 2 points this quarter. And there's the foul. It'll go on Canada. That is her first foul of the game. And a little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in this second quarter. Pass to Turner. 5 to shoot. Taurasi right side. Over Brown. And again, it's Phoenix.
An outstanding scorer who changes the game with her shooting ability. Taurasi is just so fun to watch.
Inside. Here's Holmes. Here's Brown. They set the screen. Pass to Canada. Down low. Here's Hamby. That one a little long. The Mercury Trail. Now Cunningham. And unable there to get the go-ahead bucket.
Personally, I am shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. She makes you pay on those nearly every time.
Now here's Brown. To the paint. It's stolen by Griner. And here in the second quarter of action as we approach 4 minutes played. Outside Canada. Pass to Hamby. Outside Canada. Down to 5 on the shot clock. That one off the back iron and out.
Point guard Jordan Canada spent her first 4 years in Seattle learning the one from the best, Sue Bird, serving mostly as Sue's backup, her understudy.
Turner a screen. For 3, Diana Taurasi. That shot off. And the sparks the other way now. Canada up top. To the middle. Here's Hamby. No good, and they can't put an end to this drought. And as a free agent in 2022, Jordan Canada signed with the Sparks.
A great move for Jordan, just on the personal side, because she grew up and went to college in LA. And then professionally, for the first time, Jordan was the starter, and we saw her numbers explode.
Pass to Canada. To the inside. Goes back up, and it's laid in by Hamby.
Tremendous work by Hamby, winning the rebound, and she puts it right back up for the bucket.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, it's been a long time without a bucket. Focus.
Jefferson, and misses it off the right side of the rim. And here are the Sparks now. Their defense has allowed only 4 points in the quarter. And it's Cunningham with the rebound. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Jefferson left side. Turner. Pass to Griner. Now Jefferson. Now here's Taurasi. From deep 3-point range. A rebound by Holmes.
I mean, it would have been something to see her hit from all the way back there.
There aren't many players that can hit from out there, but she's definitely one of them.
And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. The Sparks on top, up 3. And we'll step away briefly, but get you right back out there for the start of the third quarter after the break. And it's been a back-and-forth game with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter getting started here. And Ogumake has been just making it happen out here.
Her decision-making simply flawless today. Nothing but quality shots from her in the first half. She wasn't forcing anything.
Yeah, but I think here in the second half, they may want her to be a little more assertive and start taking more shots, even the tough ones.
And now, the start of the second half, neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters.
Well, as an original 1997 franchise, the Mercury didn't have a ton of success early on. However, they won their first title in 2007, year 11 of the WNBA.
That assist got a little nod from her teammate after the bucket.
And the Sparks with possession here. It's a one-point game. Ambi outside. Ogumake. And the layup is good.
And for this Mercury organization, that 2007 championship team was really memorable.
And Blake, it's not just that they won it all, it's how they did it. Leading the league in scoring by 9 points a game, playing at the fastest pace, running opponents off the floor, just a memorable style of basketball. Found the soft spot in the D right there.
About 1 minute played here in the second half. Ambi outside. Ogumake. The bank shot, no good. Pass to Taurasi. And here's Cunningham. For the lead. And the three ball is good.
Well, Cunningham has remarkable shot efficiency, and that goes back to her beautiful jump shot.
Ambi outside. Inside. Here's Ogumake. Misses off the left iron. Phoenix leading. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing in control.
Here's DeRossi. It counts, and the foul.
Basket's good.
It's going to be on Lexi Brown.
Teams are locked in on Taurasi defensively, but she's just a warrior who leaves it all out on the floor every time she's out there.
And this is her second trip to the line in the game. The Sparks making a switch here.
One shot.
And when you guys look back to draft classes in the 2010s, is there one that sticks out to you?
Well, that 2013 group was unreal. Brittany Griner, Elena Deladon, and Skylar Diggins-Smith. Those are three top picks who have all been perennial All-Stars. And in my mind, they're all Hall of Famers as well.
And I really love the 2016 class for two reasons. Brianna Stewart, Jonquil Jones, both MVPs.
Griner, no good. Sparks trailing. Just under 2.5 minutes into this third quarter now. And they call an illegal screen here.
Good call there. Her feet still moving when she set the screen.
And she sort of lowered her shoulder into her too. A move you perfected, actually. But they were going to get her there one way or the other.
Here's Cunningham. And a foul on the shot. She'll go to the stripe for two.
Kind of like the Lakers in the NBA, the Sparks are seen as the glamour franchise of the WNBA, and for a good reason. I mean, first of all, come on, let's not lie. Who doesn't want to live in LA?
Yeah, it's her first trip to the line.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one drops.
And in terms of the Sparks, there are plenty of other reasons as to why they're seen as a destination.
Well, yeah, I mean, in addition to the weather in LA, just like the Lakers, count the rings. The Sparks have been one of the most successful teams in WNBA history.
And good on the second, so she makes both.
An incredibly successful shooter in the college game. I can't wait to see everything Cunningham can do here in the pro game.
The Sparks call timeout. Just over 2.5 minutes gone by in the second half. Ambi outside.
Brown.
Ogumike outside. Pass to Ogumike.
Now Clouden.
Six to shoot.
Ambi a screen.
Over Turner. And the basket by Clouden. And here's Jefferson. Looking for her first basket still in this one. Diana Taurasi on the wing. She's covered by Ogumike. Here's Griner. Yes, and a nice assist from Diana Taurasi.
And another for Griner. She can just light up the scoreboard. Remember, she's also an all-time defensive player. She can score, she can defend. Maybe the best player in the world.
And that's a foul called on Jefferson. That's her first foul. Both teams deciding to change it up. Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now. Here's Clouden. So the whistle blows on the shot. Two free throws for the contact there.
All right, you want to talk about the best team in league history. The 2014 Mercury have to be in the conversation. 29-5 in the regular season. Then in the playoffs, they lost just one time, winning it all.
And that one misses.
And those 2014 Phoenix Mercury, man, they had a star-studded roster.
They did. Diana Taurasi and Brittany Griner were first-team All-WNBA that season. And then Griner also won Defensive Player of the Year. And then as a team, I mean, the Mercury, first in offensive and defensive rating, just a dominant 2014 season. Well, you look at the all-time numbers, and the Sparks by far have the most wins out of any WNBA team. They have really set the precedent as the on-court standard of the league.
Pass to Turner. Ogumike with the rebound.
There was just enough defensive pressure to get her off balance.
Now Holmes. Puts up a three. It's not going to go for her.
Now Onyewede.
No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. From 11 feet away.
And there's a whistle. That goes on Turner.
That's foul number two for her. It's a six-point game. Pass to Ogumike. Five on the clock. Picked off midair.
Here's Sutton. Anyanwede with it. And here's Westbrook.
And a foul on Neko Ogumike. That's her first foul.
Pass to Westbrook.
Clock at six.
Anyanwede. Here's Sutton.
Gets it to go from downtown.
A quality trip down the floor. Anyanwede providing the assist to a very open teammate.
Here's Canada. She's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard.
Now Holmes.
Down low. Here's Ogumike.
It falls for her seventh bucket of the contest. She's 7 for 9 today.
If she gets even an inch of space, she will make an opponent look very beatable.
Now Westbrook. Pass to Sutton.
And again, it's Phoenix. And the Sparks with possession here. From deep. And it would have counted had it fallen, but it's offline. And that's going to do it for the third quarter. Mercury out in front, leading by 9. And after a quick break, we're coming right back with the start of the fourth quarter. And it's time to bring up the State Farm assist of the game.
Slice the D wide open with this feed. They really had no chance to prevent this basket.
Yeah, it was a great read of the defensive setup and also wonderful anticipation of the movement of her teammates before the pass.
Welcome back as we get set to start the fourth. The Sparks trailing. Canada with it to the paint. Pass to Ogumike. Yep, that one goes.
That's how you shoot 60% in a season like she has in the past. Ogumike has done it because she is dominant near the basket.
Now here's Jefferson.
Griner up top.
Jefferson with it.
Now here's Taurasi. And the Mercury, another three.
And it's the Sparks ball.
And the outside to the inside. Here's Ogumike. Again, the Sparks good for two.
And Ogumike's teammates are feeding her for a reason. She's got the hot hand and she's riding it.
And we played through about a minute here in the fourth. Pass to Griner. Just 5 to shoot. Here's Taurasi. And a foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot 2.
It's going to be on Lexi Brown.
Never the tallest player on the floor. Taurasi uses her experience to go inside, get to the charity stripe.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
He's off on the first.
Honestly, the first thing that comes to mind anytime I see anything Phoenix Mercury related, Diana Taurasi. The top pick in the 2004 draft has spent every season in the Valley of the Sun.
She hits the second from the line.
And for Taurasi, all she's done in Phoenix is become the most accomplished player in league history.
You can just call Diana the GOAT. Rings? Yeah, she's got a few. All WNBA selections, more than a dozen. MVP? Well, of course, she's got one of those to go along with a bunch of scoring titles. I mean, you name it, DT's done it.
And the Mercury call time here.
Yeah, coach wants to get everybody on the same page out there and maybe change up some things as well.
Yeah, that's probably a good timeout. You might as well talk things through.
And kind of change that game plan as well.
A little over a minute and a half of the fourth quarter gone now. Reiner, she's covered by Ogumike. Pass to Jefferson. Six on the shot clock. Here's Reiner. Basket number eight is all good. She's attempted 12 shots.
Honestly, when she hits from this area of the court, you might as well quit. It makes Reiner almost impossible to stop. You just can't leave her out there.
And be outside to the middle. And that one's good. Ogumike.
She is setting this place on fire. Her shooting has been off the charts.
Reiner, she's covered by Ogumike. Rebound by the Sparks. For those joining us, fourth quarter here, and we're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Pass to Brown. Now Ogumike. Hamby. Turnaround Jay. Can't hit that one. Phoenix in the lead. Here's Jefferson. Guarded by Canada. Taurasi outside. And here's Cunningham.
One shot.
And that one misses. And here are the Sparks now. They trail by 9 points. Canada.
She's covered by Jefferson.
To the paint. Deflects the pass. And a fast break now for the Mercury. Fourth quarter of play and over 3.5 minutes have gone by now. Diana Taurasi on the wing. She's covered by Brown. Reiner's shot's good.
As deadly passing as shooting. Taurasi, a dual threat in the pick and roll.
Outside Canada. Ogumike. The 10-footer. And the shot goes down.
You know, you simply cannot say enough about her individual performance so far, even if the all-around team effort has been lacking.
Rossi outside. And the layup's good off the glass.
With just about every move in the book, Taurasi showing yet another dribble skill. I think she wrote the book.
Inside.
Here's Jefferson. Pass to Cunningham.
Fires for three. Doesn't go that time.
And here's Brown.
Down low. Here's Ogumike. And she makes the 8-footer.
You know, quite simply, few players make better decisions than Jordan Canada. Obviously, the right choice there.
Phoenix with the ball. They've got a 9-point lead. Pass to Taurasi. The shot off that time. And the Sparks the other way now. Ogumike, right side. Canada. Ogumike with the ball. And she drops in the layup off glass.
Such an effective player. Neka Ogumike has led the WNBA in offensive rating, a great measure of your impact on the offensive side of the ball.
Watch the gutter, watch the gutter.
Jefferson outside. Back to Griner. Ogumike with the rebound. So it's the Sparks now.
I think that deficit's too much to overcome.
You nailed it, Tim. There just isn't enough ticks on the clock.
They get the bus going, get the plane going, whatever.
Taurasi outside. And so it's Phoenix with the W. This was a hard-fought, well-earned victory for them. They really had to work for this one.
Yeah, weaker teams, they might have buckled at the end. You know, really with that crowd amped up, everyone in the building rooting against them. But they stood tall and pulled it out.
That'll do it for our broadcast, everyone.